Hello everyone, my name is Andrei Dima. I am a travel photographer and for many years I've been taking photos with film cameras, DSLRs and recently released mirrorless cameras. The things I am going to tell you in this video helped me achieve sharp photos every time with all those cameras. You just have to follow these simple rules and you are going to take sharp photos every time. The first thing, and the one that is going to annoy some people, is how you hold your camera. Try to always hold your camera with both hands, not with one hand, even when you take low-angle shots. Holding your camera with both hands helps reduce motion shake and helps when using lower shutter speeds in bad lighting conditions. It also helps you focus better with fast aperture lenses. The second thing, when shooting handheld, if your camera has image stabilization or your lens has image stabilization, or you have both, turn it on, especially in low light conditions or when using lower shutter speeds. If you're using a tripod, make sure you turn it off, because it can produce motion blur. And if you are using a tripod, make sure you have a sturdy one. It doesn't have to be the most expensive, but don't get the cheapest. Also, make sure it is set on a sturdy surface and not on sand or mud, for example. Otherwise, it is going to sink slowly in the ground and your pictures will look blurred. The third thing is your shutter speed. Lower shutter speeds can create motion blur, so in some situations, you need to have a faster shutter speed for sharp photos. A good option to avoid motion blur is by applying the general hand-holding rule, which says that the shutter speed should be equal to the focal length you are using, or faster. An example would be a 50mm focal length with no image stabilization. In this case, your shutter speed should be 1 over 50 of a second. If you have image stabilization, you can go lower. This applies to full-frame cameras. If you have a DX sensor, just multiply your length by 1.5 or 1.6 on Canon cameras. This works for steady subjects and scenes, and works well with wider lenses. Above 50mm, I usually use double the shutter speed. And for telephoto lenses, like a 200mm, you should use triple the shutter speed. If you are shooting fast-moving objects or people, you need a faster shutter speed, like 1 over 500 or even 1 over 1000 of a second. If your photos are dark when shooting with low shutter speeds and fast aperture lenses, that means you need to raise the ISO. Don't be afraid to raise the ISO. Modern cameras handle noise at higher ISOs very well. Another good option to avoid motion blur when shooting with lower shutter speeds is to use a tripod. When shooting long exposures, always use a remote or a self-timer and keep your ISO at minimum, which in most cases is 100. Number 4, and in my opinion the most important, the focus. Having your subject in focus is very important if you want sharp photos. Having the right autofocus settings for the right situation is very important. Use autofocus single for static objects, landscapes and portraits, and autofocus continuous for moving subjects, birds, people in motion and cars. The next important part is to know which focus area to use and when. For most uses, like portraits, landscape, architecture, use the single point. This allows you to select exactly where you want the camera to focus. Let's say if you are taking a portrait shot, you can put the focus point on the eye. If you have eye detect on your camera, even better, enable that when taking portraits. Use the dynamic or tracking for moving subjects, sports, animals, kids, etc. When you use a tripod for landscape or long exposures, use your live view mode or back screen to achieve perfect focus by zooming in and focusing manually where you want your photo to be the sharpest, or use focus peaking. The fifth thing, sometimes it helps to raise or lower your lens aperture. Let's say you have a 50mm f1.8 lens and you want to take a portrait photo with shallow depth of field. You take the photo at f1.8 and you don't like the results. This could be three things. 1. You are too close to the subject and the focus area is too narrow, so just a small part is in focus. This can be solved by raising the aperture at f2.8 or f3.2 to increase the focus area. 2. Your lens is not that sharp at that aperture, and you need to raise or lower it. Most lenses are not sharp at their fastest aperture, so stopping down a bit helps. And the third, almost all lenses become soft after f10 or f11 because of diffraction. Also, all lenses have a sweet spot, an aperture that is the sharpest on that lens. You should check online what is your lens sweet spot. Other short tips: clean your lens and your camera sensor. If you are using a DSLR, it is possible your lens is back focusing or front focusing. This means you should go to a professional service to recalibrate it. Mirrorless cameras and their lenses, from what I know, do not suffer from this problem. It is very disappointing when you go to a special place or a favorite event and come back with blurry photos. We all want to take sharp photos, and with a bit of practice and these simple rules, you will. Always check your settings before taking a photo. In many cases, people forget to do this, and that is one of the reasons they don't get sharp photos. With time, all these rules and things you need to do will come to you naturally. No one learned photography in one day, so go out and practice. One more thing I want to say: if you are a beginner, try to invest first in lenses. These are more important than your camera. If you have poor quality glass and a high resolution sensor, you won't get the sharpest photos. So it is better to start with good quality glass and a second-hand older camera. When you're going to have enough money to buy the camera you want, you will be very happy you have good lenses to get the most out of it. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please like and subscribe. This helps me grow my channel and make more videos like this for you to watch. If you like my photos, check out my presets pack and prints in the description below. See you next time.